So we are here at the Robert Garcia Boxing Academy in Oxnard. Robert, it's fight week. One more week. Gennady Golovkin Rubio, how are you feeling?
On Wednesday. We're already in Carson on Wednesday.
Wednesday is the media workout. Yeah, Thursday, the press conference. Friday, the weigh-in. Saturday, the fight.
We're there Wednesday. We leave Wednesday morning. We'll see everybody there, man. Hopefully, we get a lot of support right there.
Rubio looks almost on weight to me. No,
he's close to weight. He's trained hard, man. And we got Chef Chan, who does a great job, man. Chef Chan is unbelievable when it comes to cooking. I don't want to recommend him out there because I want him for myself because I need him every fucking day.
You have a big stable.
After Rubio, we got to continue. You know what I mean? We got to continue. Brandon's going to fight in January. The Russian's fighting. All my other guys continue fighting. He even works for all the six-round fights, you know. He works for everybody.
Do you know who Brandon is fighting yet? Did they announce
it? We don't know. But I'm told that January 31st, well, of course it's not official. Maybe I shouldn't even be saying this, but I've been told that it's January 31st against the third fight, Alvarado. That's what I've heard.
That'll be good.
That's what
they've told. But they didn't say where. They just said it might.
No, they haven't said nothing. It's like I said, it's not even official yet.
But that'll be huge, at least, you know.
Oh, yeah, it'll be a big-ass fight. Shoot, yeah.
So Brandon's Alvarado 3, that's the first two were very exciting. Fight of the year, the first one, absolutely.
Yeah, no, definitely.
At the Home Depot Center.
Definitely, you know. Second one, Alvarado fought smart, moved around, and won a decision. You know, this fight's going to be another hell of a fight, man. Another hell of a fight.
What's your next fight after Golovkin?
After Rubio, we have...
Evgeny?
No, but well, if you want to talk big fights,
yeah.
Evgeny. But then next week... The final week, I go to Colorado to maybe do the go.
Oh, U.S. Women National Team.
U.S. Women National Team's got a tournament, I think, a fight against Korea.
Okay. Are you going to go check it out, help them out?
So I'm not going to go over there because I can't because of the fights that the schedule that I have. But I'm going. Me and Pete are going to USA training camp.
That's awesome.
In Colorado Springs for that week after the fight. Then I come back for because I have we have... Eric fighting.
Eric Ruiz fighting Jesse Magdaleno.
And that's in
Fresno.
And then I come back. I go back to Colorado for another week. And then when I come back, then the last 2 weeks, I'm gonna be with Igis and Alexander. They both fight in San Antonio, Texas. Hey, so it's gonna be either me or Marcos. With one or the other.
Yeah.
You know, San Antonio with Igis and Alexander. And then, of course, Evgeny,
you're fighting Jason Velez.
Jason Velez.
Now it's official.
Already on weight. Look at him. Already on weight.
The punching machine.
Take it easy.
Hey, take it easy when he was fighting. That's what they yelled out.
On the 29th. We got him on the 29th. And then we got... December with the rest of the guys. The Russians are going to fight again in December. I talked to Cameron yesterday. Saul Rodriguez Nando will be fighting. I think he's going to try to go to two fights before the end of the year. So November and December.
That's awesome. The kid needs to be active.
And then Brandon again in January if the fight happens. Just got to stay busy, man. Oh, and then I have Cuellar. Where gets your Saturday?
Oh, really?
Because he's going to fight again in December.
Do you know who?
No, we don't know, but he's fighting in December.
Is it a big fight?
Well, he's going to defend his title. Yeah, it'll be big.
But I'm saying like one of the big names.
I don't know. Nah, probably not.
What about
big name? Probably till next year.
Mikey, any new updates?
My brother? Nothing, bro.
Still waiting?
Nothing, bro. It's sad, bro, because honestly, you know, my dad is calling me every day. Talk to Cameron. Have you talked to Todd? We don't even talk about Mikey anymore. You know why? Because I think Cameron can't talk about Mikey anymore. So
just waiting for that situation.
Just waiting. I guess that's business attorneys are taking care of. You know what I mean? I wish I could fucking make a decision right now and Mikey be fighting fucking next week. You know what? If I could make the decision, but. You know, Mike's attorneys are handling that, so we're letting them do that.
From gym to gym, people tell me Mikey is the future of boxing. They love the way he fights. They love the way he keeps his hands up.
Look, if Mikey gets this thing going fast and fights, hopefully, I'm hoping by the end of the year, December,
he fights. That'll be awesome.
Look, he'll fight at 135. Then he goes up to 140. fights a big name at 140. He's in position to fight even Mayweather.
Yeah.
Mayweather's last fight. Is
You're right.
Or, you know, Mayweather will be 49-0, right?
Maybe Pacquiao.
Maybe Pacquiao, you know. But Mayweather's going to be 49-0 when he retires.
Yeah, that's true.
That's the looks. Yeah. 49-0. So why wouldn't he go to fight for the 50th time? Retire at 50-0, if that's what he wants.
Yeah.
Maybe Mikey could be his 50th fight. No, maybe it won't be 50-0, but you know what I mean? Mikey's that skill. He's got those skills.
Mikey Danny Garcia, Mikey Broner, Mikey Terrence Crawford.
Exactly.
Mikey.
Look at that. So how many fights?
Mikey Ruslan.
How many fights are there?
Endless.
Endless. Endless to make Mikey a superstar. He's got to clear the shit. You know, he's got to fucking this shit.
And just make it happen.
Make it happen, bro.
There you have it, Robert Garcia, EsNews.com, and Melissa Quack reporting.